you mentioned businesses, and I think that goes back to a point that someone else was making. It's important for the precinct to have a relationship, a working relationship with businesses. Our job is not simply to shut down every bar that presents some challenges for us.
And there are
some who come to me constantly, how do you let this operate, how do you let that operate? Our job is to work with business, because if we shut down a bunch of businesses, you have a bunch of closed down businesses on the street. Now, having said that, there are times where a business just becomes too much of a danger to the community. I think a very good example of that is the closure of Tete that took place recently. Tete had presented challenges for us. There was some felony assault on New Year's Day. At about 4 a.m, I was in there. There were a lot of people assaulted in a brawl. There were some other violations that had taken place there. We took several steps to work with that business. And then on, of course, Mother's Day, May 10th, we had two people who exited there along with some patrons from in there. There was the dispute outside where two people were shot and a person was killed. And all of those people came out of Tete. The Friday after that, we did an operation there between the 34th Precinct, State Liquor Authority, Workman's Compensation Board. And the results of that, violations that were issued there, in addition to their previous violations, resulted in them being temporarily shut down for that weekend, and their liquor license was subsequently revoked the following Tuesday. So there are situations where I think a certain business represents more problems than a neighborhood can handle, and that's not just being brought by the NYPD, but a joint operation between SLA and workers' compensation. So I think we look at each situation on its individual merits and on the totality of the circumstances that happens in a business before we have to take such drastic action. I have a Gary, forgive me if I